Welcome to the Time to Fly podcast. It's time to give your business wings and take flight to achieve more impact, influence, and income with unique perspectives, tools, and tips from successful entrepreneurs and business professionals to help your business fly. Here to educate, encourage, and entertain you with their own unique perspectives and experience, plus sharing anecdotes of growing up as cowgirls. Here's your host, Nikole Haumont.
Welcome to this episode of Time to Fly, Give Your Business Wings. I'm your host, Nikole Haumont. Today, I want to visit about building a community in real life and online. Moving across country two different times in my adult life has taught me a few things to hit the ground running and to build a fast community. When you build a fast community, it doesn't mean you can't build a solid community. It just takes a little bit more effort and time on your part to get to the solid part. In 2002, I started a magazine with a business partner in Rapid City, South Dakota. It was a horse publication, and people in that area knew who we were because my business partner was very involved in the horse industry her entire life, and I had been working for a regional livestock publication, plus I had been running for Miss Rodeo, South Dakota, and my family was from that area. So people knew who we were when we started the business, and we were able to build it and then successfully sell it 2 days before I got married in 2008. During that time, though, I had moved 750 miles from Rapid City to Cedar Rapids, Iowa, so I could be with my then fiance and make sure that we actually liked each other, because we had dated long distance for 19 months. After moving to Iowa, it was a big shock to me because I didn't know anybody other than my husband. I had grown up in an area and had spent my first 28 years of life in the same tri-state area of Montana, Wyoming, and South Dakota, and everybody knew who I was. My mom's side of the family had settled in the area in 1904. Believe me, people knew who I was. And it was easy to always meet people because I could ask so-and-so, who do you know? Move to Iowa? Not as easy. But I went with an open mind, knowing that this was going to be my home for the foreseeable future, and this is where I wanted to build a life with my husband. Fast forward a few months, and I was in Walmart in the fabric clearance section of all places, where I met a lady who was in a networking group. I happened to introduce myself, we bonded over a piece of fabric, and we started a conversation. This conversation led me to joining a networking group called BNI. You've probably heard of it. It is one of the largest organizations in the world. Being a part of that really set me up to meet a lot of people in a short amount of time, and I was actually a member of that group for about 9 years. Then my husband was recruited, and we knew we were moving to Southern Arizona. This time, I took all of my skills that I had learned and honed over the last 9 years, and I built a network much faster here in Sahuarita. Having the choice of where we were going to live, whether it was in Tucson, Vail, or Sahuarita, my husband and I did a lot of research. Of course, school was our number one priority, but my number two priority was what would be the best move for my business to grow. So I had done a lot of research, and I determined that Sahuarita Green Valley area was going to be a good place for us. Plus, there is a master plan community here that we absolutely love living in. With the move across country, I was like, I need to hit the ground running because Lincoln is going to be in school soon as a kindergartner, and I will have a lot more time during the day. And I'm one of those people, the more busy I am, the more I get done. And so I knew, instead of only having 2 or 3 hours here and there, that I was going to have a longer span of time, I needed to make sure I kept growing my business. Otherwise, I would probably do nothing. That's just the way I work. So the first thing I did was start to get to know the lay of the land. I went to the different chamber events that were going on. At this point in time, I was not a member of the chamber, but there were trade shows and things like that where I could go and meet people. And then I did join the Chamber of Commerce here. And the reason I chose Green Valley Sahuarita for the main part was in the chamber, there were no website designers or social media managers, and that really made a big difference for me in saying this is a good place for me to expand my business. Now, I'm actually a co-chair of the Marketing and Promotions Committee for the Chamber of Commerce because I have shown up, I have volunteered to help, and people know who I am. I will tell you this, having the CEO of the chamber and the president of the board of directors of the chamber know who you are and know what you do is good for your business. I also, during this time, co-founded another networking group based off of what I had learned with the BNI chapter in Cedar Rapids, Iowa. So we now have a group called Advantage Alliance that meets every 2 weeks. This group was formed by myself and Brandy Chase, a life coach here in Sahuarita, and we chose the first members and specifically invited them based on what they did career-wise and how well connected they were within the community. Our core group that started with about 10 people has grown to 15 people in less than 6 months, and we've already passed over $20,000 worth of business within this small group. The reason I like having a networking group to go to is, one, every 2 weeks I get to practice my elevator pitch of what do you do? Two is it helps me exchange ideas with other business owners. And three, I can establish myself as an expert. Now, there was another networking group already here, and I could have joined that group because there were no website designers or social media managers in there. However, I chose to start my own group because of the research I had done and the people I had visited with. I really felt like there was a chance to have a second group that we could develop into the way we wanted. I'm one of those people that if I can start it myself, I like to do that because it establishes me as an expert. As long as I do a good job. So hopefully I am doing a good job keeping the Advantage Alliance moving forward. Another reason that I really like networking groups is, dependent upon how many members you have that many sales reps out there listening and telling people about your services and products. We are a referral networking group. We only allow one of each type of business. And so that means those people establish relationships with me and vice versa. And our goal is to find business for each other. We track all of the metrics to make sure people are actually contributing members of the group. And if they're not, we have in our bylaws and rules ways to encourage them either to step up their game or step out the door. Another way to grow your community fast when you've moved, or even if you're wanting to just restart in your own community that you're in, is connect with people on Facebook and LinkedIn that are in your area. On both places, you can do searches for your specific area and go through and look. Here where we live, we actually have a very active community group, which introduced me to several different people. And I also joined our church. And between our church and the Facebook group, I've met a lot of other business owners, and I've invited them to lunch. I've invited them out to our meeting. I've invited them to other things because that way I could get to know them. So don't be afraid to send a message, send a text, actually pick the phone up and invite somebody to lunch. You may not be able to connect on the first time that you try, but maybe the second, third, or fourth time you actually can. And of course, if you don't want to commit to a full hour of lunch, maybe just a cup of tea somewhere would be perfect too. But you have to initiate it, because I know it can be scary to initiate that phone call or that text message or that message, but it is something you need to do if you want to build relationships within your community that you see people in real life. From my affiliation with our church, I actually have a couple of different people from there that joined our referral networking group. So by developing those relationships and volunteering to be on the marketing committee, it was another way for me to meet more people and establish myself as an expert in my field. So I'm going to challenge you to reach out to 5 people locally over the next 5 weeks, 1 person per week, and invite them to lunch or invite them to coffee. Or if you really want to get it going, invite them to a networking meeting where you know you can introduce them to other people. And if there is no networking groups in your area, you should probably start one. Why not be the leader when it comes to that? Now we're going to take a quick sponsor break. And when we come back, I'm going to talk about ways to build your online community.
This episode is sponsored by Shield Bar Marketing, saving service-based businesses time, money, and frustration. More than just a designer, but a partner helping you develop a consistent online and offline strategy.
We are back. So while we were on break, did you think of that one person to invite to lunch this week? Who is it? How are you going to reach out to them? Answer those questions and then listen in for the rest. Now, when it comes to building a community online, of course, Facebook and LinkedIn are my 2 favorite ways to go. But there's a lot of different tools out there where you can use them to help facilitate those relationships. I like to do Zoom calls if at all possible because you can do face-to-face. Those are video conferencing. Zoom just happens to be the platform I use. There's other ways that you can have face-to-face conversations, whether it's on your phone or computer. But that facilitates being able to have eye contact and develop a better relationship. Of course, you can always pick up the phone and call. Me personally, I'd prefer to text first and, you know, kind of set an appointment, because if you just randomly call me, I may be in the middle of something. And I try to respect other people's time that way too. But a text message or an email first saying, hey, do you have time to chat, makes it a lot easier, because then they can wrap up the project they're working on and you can wrap up the project you're working on and set a mutually agreed time. You also can reach out to people through Facebook Messenger, through LinkedIn Messenger, or whatever other social platform you like, and private message them and just say, hey, how are you doing? It's been a while since we talked, and leave it at that. Then when they reply to you, you can start a conversation, or you can jump on a phone call, or you can jump on a Zoom. It's one of those things that reaching out to people, whether it's a weekly thing or a monthly thing, if you go through your friends list and your connections list, you can find people to reach out to. One of my favorite virtual ways I have recently started participating in is being part of a business book club. So each week we meet for about half hour to 45 minutes via a Zoom call. There's about 10 of us in our group and we're spread out all across the country, but we're all reading the same book. And what we do is we read 2 to 3 chapters. It's assigned ahead of time. And then we sit and we discuss those chapters and how they apply to our life and our business. So depending on what your interests are, whether you're into cooking or you're into art or you want to do business building or you want to do work on yourself with self-improvement, put together a virtual group of people who all have the same interest and pick a book. You may need to be the facilitator on it to get it going, but by doing a virtual book club, you can expand your network across the country easily. You never know who you're going to meet online, and I would honestly open it up to about 20 people, because every week is a big commitment to show up, and so you're probably only going to have half of them there. And then ask them, you know, 3 takeaways, 1 takeaway from each chapter, and discuss what is going on. Now, this book club I did not start, but it was one that I was asked to join, and I met people from Minnesota, Wisconsin, Utah, and here in Arizona. And the book club actually does have 3 other local people that I get to see in real life. So it's a great way to expand your knowledge, read new books, and challenge yourself to learn about other people. So what I'm going to challenge you to do on virtual community building is I want you to reach out to 5 people over the next 5 weeks and just send them a message and say, hey, how are you doing? It's been forever since we've talked. That's if you have ever talked to them. If it's somebody you've connected with and you've never really had a conversation with them, that first initial conversation, you can be honest and say, hey, we're friends or we're connections. And my goal this year is to make 1 connection a week and find out more. How can I help you with your business goals or life goals, whatever your question is? And this is not a sales pitch. This is truly being interested in the other party and finding out who they know, what they need, and how you can help them. The more people you make connections with like that, the more people you can connect to other people. And every time you make a connection to other people for people, it reminds them, Nikole introduced me and Nikole does XYZ. So that's the challenge for you this week, is 1 person this week virtually and 1 person in real life. So in summary, in real life networking, join a church or another community similar to that. Join the Chamber of Commerce or perhaps the Rotary, something that's going to put you in with other like-minded people. Start or join a referral networking group. Those are all great ways to build your local community. Online community building? Start a book club or join one. Don't be afraid to jump on and do a Zoom, a Facebook call, or an actual phone call. You can always reach out via LinkedIn Messenger, Facebook Messenger, or send a text if you have their phone number. There are a ton of ways to build your community and keep in touch with people that you've known for a long time. So, as I said, I'm challenging you to reach out to 1 person in real life and 1 person virtually and start building your community today. Be sure to join us for our next show of Time to Fly. Give your business wings.
A big thank you to this episode's sponsor, Shield Bar Marketing. Be sure to visit shieldbar.com for all your marketing needs.
Join our flock. Stay informed of all things Time to Fly by subscribing to our newsletter at timetoflypodcast.com. And be sure to tune in to our next show.